Now, we are going to test our graphical user interface. More precisely, the two buttons will check if they are working. So I go to Start. It's going to take a bit of time. Usually, you know, Visual Studio will check if the viruses are there. You can see it here. But I'm going to close it because it tells me we are fine. Don't want to check the viruses now. You can see the blue turning and the app is here. I'm just going to play with these two. I click on PhD student and we can see the PhD student. Now I click on the PhD examiner and it has switched to the PhD examiner. Again, if I go to PhD student, you can see the picture of the student studying. And if I switch to PhD examiner, now you can see the picture of the PhD examiner with a little bit of money, the staff number, the alphabet, and so on. So it looks like it is working. Let me close this one, stop the app, and try to go to the third part, which is the coding of the OK button. You can see I slightly clicked here where the cursor is on the OK button. How do we code the OK button? I double click. After double clicking, it will open a space for me to write the code. Okay. Now we have to make use of the classes that we did initially code. It was person, it was PhD student, and it was a PhD examiner. We have to code them under the button. Double click button, like I said, and the space is ready for the code. How do we start? We have two types of students. So we'll ask which radio button was actually checked. If I go quickly to the interface, I can see that this radio button here, it's a radio button. I'm moving my cursor. It's radio button one. This radio button one here is for the student. Radio button one is for the student. Now let me click on the examiner. What's the name of that one? I can go to, you can see radio button two. Okay, to cut a long story short, the radio button one is for the student and radio button two is for the examiner. Okay, let me go back to my OK button and ask if radio button one, dot, okay, I didn't want to say bottom, I wanted to say button one, dot, checked. It means, did you select the student? Is equal true. Did you select the student? Okay, that's the question I'm asking. If you selected the student, then what is it going to happen? I am going to create a student. Okay, how did we call a student? It was PhD student. Right, so the person that I'm creating is a new PhD student. And open no parameter is the default constructor. What are we doing on this line? We're declaring a person P from which class? From the class PhD student. So this is now an object. And that person, we create then a new PhD student. Okay, I'm going with the convention that all objects are capital, so I'll call it capital P instead of small p. Very good. Now we have a person, we want to populate the data of that person, which means the first name of the person, the surname of the person, the ID number of the person, the birth date. Since he's a student, it also needs a student number, one mark for the internal examiner, and the other mark for the external examiner. But remember, we had a function that we call